Hi everyone, Leon here. Today I want to share a composition I wrote for harp, voice, and piano libraries from VSL. After the demo, I will break down my composition and share my experience with you regarding the libraries. So make sure you stick around if you're interested. I hope you enjoyed this demo. So as I mentioned earlier, this composition features multiple VSL libraries, and I wanted to do a quick breakdown of the composition and then talk a little bit about the plugins. So I started kind of messing around with the harp library, and I came up with this ostinato figure, which is in 5-4, and it's in C harmonic minor with mysterious vibes. And this ostinato inspired me to add a female voice with long sustaining notes, which introduces a new melody. And with that high note, I bring in the piano with a big chord to support the weight of the soprano, starting with a low octave C. With little descending twinkles in there. So then the piano continues with this rhythmic figure in 5-4 and centric around C. At the same time, the harp does a glissando here. As well as the soprano sustaining. So altogether, it sounds something like this. At this point, I felt like the mood needed to change a bit, so I modulated to A minor, which is a minor third down from C minor. And I brought in the whistle to highlight the change even more. It still has that mysterious feel in it, but it's more, there's more motion, more storytelling in there. The whistle, it sounds very realistic. There is that breathy feel in there. So in the later section, the piano starts building up again, along with the soprano and baritone duo. It's very lyrical, and it's supporting what the piano is doing there. Let me play the voices first. Now let me play it with the piano. And here in the next section, we have subito piano, very dramatic change. Only with the harp. So it's kind of a sequence of harmonic changes happening one after another. And then moving on, that's where probably the most climactic section of the composition is, where everyone joins in except the harp, which comes in later. But we have, I decided to add the choir here as well because I wanted a much larger sound, and again for the choir from BSL. Let me quickly show you the dynamic range in the choir. And along with the solo voices doing this. So they're kind of contrasting with the dynamic motion. And then at the end, the last section we have here, it's retreating into going back to the beginning. And I just wanted to end it like that with a little bit of suspense. It feels unstable. I just want to briefly talk about the sample libraries I used in this composition. So for piano, I used the Bösendorfer from the Synchron pianos. And it's a pretty straightforward library. It comes with three main windows here. So on the play window, you can adjust reverb, volume, dynamic, as well as you have the pedal options here, and then some other fine-tuning parameters that you can adjust to your liking. For this demo, I used the intimate preset. But then if you want to select concert or other presets here, so for concert it has more reverbs. And with pop, it's a little bit closer, much brighter. Moving on to the mix window, we have all these mic positions that we can select from. The intimate preset By default, it has the room mix and the condenser positions loaded, but we can also pick other mic positions and mix them together and adjust the levels. Some mids. You can also adjust the EQ and some other plugins that comes with it. And then finally, in the edit window, we have the velocity curve that you can adjust, as well as some other global settings like half pedal range or MIDI sensitivity and so on. Moving on to synchronized voices. From this collection, I use two solo voices, a choir preset, and a whistler. They all share the same interface. On the right side, you can see the presets and categories here. In the lower section, we have all the controllers and parameters such as expression, velocity sensitivity, envelope, tuning, and mixing options. In the top section, we have vowels, articulations, and techniques, and each of them has a dedicated key switch labeled right next to them. So going back to my demo, these are the key switches I used, and here you can see which parameter is getting triggered. I pretty much did the same thing for the baritone voice, but for the choir and whistler, I didn't use any key switches. I just controlled the dynamics manually. In case you wanted to use other articulations, just like solo voices, you can use key switches to trigger other articulations if you like. Now let's talk about SYNCHRON-ized Harp Library. It comes with an interesting learning curve, especially if you're like me and don't like to read manuals. I just like to install plugins and kind of explore them on my own. Sometimes that's not the best decision, because you end up doing things the harder way. After recording my harp track, I realized there was a much better way of doing it. So here's what I learned. This library has two modes, chromatic and pedal. In chromatic mode, you can basically play it like a piano. It doesn't require any key switches. If you're playing harp-specific techniques, such as glissando, that's when the pedal mode comes in handy. As you see in the virtual keyboard, all these different colors indicate key switches for different techniques, scale modes, key signatures, and how pedal works on a real harp. So let's say I want to play a glissando in C harmonic minor. If I play it in chromatic mode, it's going to play unwanted notes outside of that key signature. Whereas in a pedal mode, I can simply click on this and it will play only the notes of the selected mode, just like a real harp. Honestly, I didn't think of the chromatic mode at the time of recording the demo. Later, I realized I could have easily played many of the passages in chromatic mode without having to program all the key switches. I mean, with both modes, you end up getting the same audio recording quality. It's just more efficient to use the pedal mode only when needed. I do want to point out that in the pedal mode, you can save your own presets and navigate through them with stepper buttons so you don't have to enter multiple key switches manually in your DAW. That's particularly useful for live performances, so you don't have to remember all these key switches. Select the preset that you like, right-click on the stepper button, and click Save. So for my demo, I saved a sequence of multiple stepper buttons. I really enjoyed working on this project and found these libraries extremely inspiring to work with. You have so much control over every little detail of the instrument, and I hope you get a chance to try them. I hope you found this video helpful. If you made it this far, thank you so much for watching, and please feel free to share your thoughts in the comment section. I will see you in the next video.